please give it up for Gabbi Nucci!
I decided to take stand-up comedy to get over my shyness. I think it worked. I love to dance. I have a ballet teacher who's fun, but a little crazy. In a good way. You know, like Becky. She's like a character from the 80s. Always tan, bleach blonde hair, and long red nails. I think she misses dancing because she's always trying to show us what she can still do. See that, girls? I still got it, girls! See, girls? Do it like this! Kelly, get me up! My mom has two personalities when she drives. There's the nice, suburban New Jersey Patty. So beautiful. Then there's the angry, aggressive New York City Patty. You cut me off, you dummy! It's like the Lincoln Tunnel is a portal to foul-mouthed Mama Land. My grandpa's Italian, but he thinks he's more Italian than he really is. He's from that well-known Italian village of Belleville, New Jersey. He thinks that speaking Italian means adding an A and a hand gesture to the end of everything. He says, Gabriella, Luca, I see a cow. The other night, we went out to a restaurant with him. He was trying so hard to be so Italian that when the waitress asked if he wanted dessert, he said, "Yes, sir! Double espresso for everyone!" I'm Catholic, and I go to church every Sunday. The good thing about church is that I get to see my friends sing, eat snacks, and drink wine. But I also have a problem with the church. Church is Germ City. All of those people interacting and sharing stuff. I have some solutions though. Problem one. Everyone dips their fingers in that bowl of holy water and then touches their face with it. Answer, replace it with Purell. Problem two. The priest hands out the body of Christ and actually puts it on people's tongues. With his bare hands! Answer, a value pack of Costco rubber gloves. Problem three, the wine goblet. Everyone in the church drinks from it, and then the priest just cleans it like this. Answer, the blood of Christ in Dixie cups. Church is the pressure at penance. When you're Catholic, you basically go into a booth the size of a closet and tell a priest, aka a stranger, all of the things you've done wrong. I'm not even supposed to talk to strangers. It's weird meeting someone for the first time like that. I'm always like, hi, my name's Gabbi, I like cheese, and I'm a Capricorn. Now tell me a little bit about yourself. It's like Catholic speed dating. I'm a pretty good kid. So when the priest asks me if my sins, they sound kind of lame. I'm like, I borrowed my sister's jeans? The problem is, I don't want to bore him, so I end up making up sins. I lie to a priest! The other day, after confession, I felt bad that I lied. So I went back to the booth, and I was like, ding dong. Hiya, it's me again. You know all those sins? Well, I lied. That counts, right? Do you ever see those drug commercials on TV? I saw one yesterday, and they're like, if you have dry eyes, you should try Vistasis. Side effects maybe, rash, fever, swelling, bleeding, thoughts of suicide, or death. Death is not a side effect. And even if you don't have side effects and end up not dying, thoughts of suicide? What? I think I'd rather have dry eyes. Thank you.